Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our science session. So as we know, we are learning the lesson that is separation of substances. So in the separation of the substances, we have discussed some points. We have discussed that why is it necessary to separate the substances. Also we have seen some methods. Which methods? That how to separate the solid subcomponents from a mixture. In that already we have discussed about the hand picking method, threshing and the winnowing. And now one more method is remain, that with the help of that we can separate out the solid components from a mixture, that is nothing but what? Sieving. Okay. So what is mean by the sieving? So as we know, might be you have seen in your kitchen that your mother is using the one type of the one type of the instrument, we can say the one type of the thing is used to sieve the flour. Okay. So what is mean by the sieve? Sieving is the one type of the process. Okay. So let's say what is mean by the sieving first. So sieving, the method of separating the components of a mixture that are of different sizes by using a sieve is called sieving. Okay. So the sieving is the one type of the method of the separating components. Which type of the components? From a mixture that are of different size. If the substances or the components are having a different size, then we can separate out that substance components from the mixture with the help of the sieving method. Size is by using a sieve is called sieving. Okay, so the sieving we can use to separate out the solid components from a mixture, but if that components are having the different sizes, then only we can use this sieving method. So we can do this method with the help of the sieve. Now what is mean by the sieve? Sieve is the shallow vessels which are having the so many pores or the so many holes on it, and with the help of that different sizes particle, whatever the big particles are there, it will get collected on the upper side of the sieve and the smaller particles comes down with the help of the sieve. So you can see here in the image how exactly the sieve is there. Okay. By using that we can do this sieving method. This sieve we can use in the kitchen to sieve to do the sieving of the flour, which helps to separate out the rice wheat bran from the flour. Also might be you have seen in during the construction places or on the construction sites, you can see like this big sieve. Okay, so with the help of this big sieve we can separate out the sand, the different particles from the sand, and we can get the fine sand that we are using for the plasters and for other purposes. Okay, so this is about what? Sieving. Okay, so for this sieving we are having one activity. So let's see this activity.
Sieving. This is the method used to separate components of a mixture present in different sizes. Example: sieves are used to separate pebbles and stones from sand.
Also, my dear student, in our previous video we have discussed about the winnowing. And for winnowing, what we are doing? We are removing the smaller or the lighter particles from the heavier particles. So for that also we are having an activity. So we will go through that activity.
It is the process used to separate heavier and lighter components of a mixture by blowing air. Farmers use this method to separate lighter husk particles from heavier seeds of grain. Separated husk is used as fodder for cattle.
Okay, so now we will move for the next point from the lesson, that is we are going to discuss about separation of insoluble solids from a liquid. Okay, it is very important. We are going to separate out the insoluble solids from a liquid. Okay, insoluble solids from a liquid. So for that we are going to see the first method, that is sedimentation and decantation. Okay, what is mean by the sedimentation and the decantation? So the sedimentation and the decantation, it is the one type of the method which is used to separate out the insoluble heavier particles from the liquid or from the water. It is very important which type of the particles or which type of the components we can separate out from the water: heavier and insoluble. If the components are heavier and insoluble, then we can separate out the components with the help of this decantation and the sedimentation method. So let's see, for that we are having one activity. So let's perform that activity. So see here, I am having this one beaker. Okay, I am having this one beaker. In this beaker, I will add some sand. Okay, I will take some amount of the sand in it. Okay, see here, I have taken some amount of the sand in it. Okay, now I will add some amount of the water in this. Okay, so here we get the solution of the sand. Okay, in that we have added the sun sand, so we got the solution of the sand. Now what we will do? Now we'll allow this solution to keep settle for the some time. With the help of that, what happens? Whatever the heavier particles are there, whatever the heavier and the insoluble particles are there, that all the particles will get settled down at the bottom of the beaker, and for that we are calling as what? Sedimentation process. For that process only we are calling as what? Sedimentation process. So what is meant by the sedimentation? The settled down of the insoluble heavier particles at the bottom of the beaker, and that process is called as what? Sedimentation. And whatever the amount or the whatever the components are get settled at the bottom of the beaker, and that is called as what? Sediment. Okay, so the layer of what? Sediment. What is meant by the sediment? The layer which is get settled at the bottom of the beaker, which is heavier, which is insoluble in the water, that layer it is called as what? Sediment. Okay, so see here, now we are having that sediment. Okay, so see here, you can see the one layer, darker layer is there, that is what? Sediment. Okay, at the bottom of the beaker you can see the sediment. Okay, so which process we have done? We allow this sediment, or we allow this heavier particle, insoluble particle, to settle at the bottom of the liquid, which is called as what? Sedimentation process. And the layer of the insoluble heavier particle which is settled at the bottom of the beaker, which is called as what? Sediment. Okay, so it is called as what? Sediment. Now what we will do? Now we will separate this upper water without disturbing the sediment. Okay, without disturbing the layer of the sediment, we will separate out this water. And now I am performing the method that is only called as what? Decantation. This process is called as what? Decantation. So without disturbing the layer of the sediment, we have to remove the upper water or the upper layer of the water, and that process is called as what? That process is called as what? Decantation. Now see here, this is what? Sediment. And here we have removed this water, and now which process I have performed? That is what? Decantation. Okay, so in this way, this is what? Sedimentation. And decantation process is used to separate out the heavier insoluble particles from the water or from the liquid. Okay, now we will move for the next one, that is filtration. Now filtration, this is the process that also we are performing in our house every day. Whenever we are having the tea, then our mother is using the strainer to strain or to filter the tea. Okay, so here to filter the tea, our mother is using what? Strainer. Strainer means what? Which are having the certain holes on it, and with that holes the tea leaves or the tea powders cannot comes out. Only the tea or the liquid tea comes out in the tea cup. Okay, and on that strainer we can see all the tea powder. Okay, why is it happens? Because that strainer, it acts as a filter. But these strainers we cannot use to filter the water or to filter the muddy water. Why? Because this muddy water contains the very fine, very small, very tiny particles of the mud, and along with that water, that muddy particle or that mud particle also comes out with the help of that strainer. Okay, so which thing we have to use to separate out or to remove or to filter the muddy water? We have to use the filter paper. Okay, so see here, I am having this filter paper. So like this filter paper we have to use to do the separation or to do the filtration of the muddy water. So this filter paper is the paper which are having the millions of the tiny holes on it. Okay, So with the naked eyes we cannot see that millions of the tiny pores on it. If we want to observe that, then we have to use the electron microscope. Okay. So with the help of this tiny millions of the pores, only the water gas comes out, but cannot comes out the muddy particles or the mud particles. Okay. So this is about what filter paper. So to perform that method with the help, or to purify the water by using this filter paper, that method is called as what? Filtration. So we can say that the process of separating of the substances, so the process of separating of the insoluble substances from a liquid with the help of the filter paper, that method is called as what? Filtration. Okay, so the separating of the insoluble substances from a liquid with the help of the filter paper, then that method is called as what? Filtration. Okay. So to understand this method, we are having one activity. So let's perform this activity to separate a mixture of a mud and water by filtration method. So for this, I have taken this filter paper. Now I will fold this filter paper first like this. Two times I will fold it, and next one like this. Okay. So like this we have done, and now the one layer or the one part I will take. Like this, and here are the three parts. Okay, and here is the one part, and now this one part I will keep into like this cone shape we have to make of that filter paper, and we have to insert it into the funnel. Okay, we have to insert it into the funnel, and now this funnel we have to keep it on a conical flask. Okay, it is called as what? Conical flask. And now this muddy water. Now what we will do, without disturbing or without any disturbance, slowly I will add some muddy water over this filter paper. Okay, over this filter paper. Now I have started to pour the water on this filter paper. So it having very tiny hole, so it will take some time to filter that water. But after filtration, okay, after filtration, see the color of the water. And after filtration also, again I will show you the color of the water. Now you can see it is the muddy water. After filtration, at the bottom of the conical flask, we will get the clear water. Okay, we will get the clear water, and that is only called as what? Filtrate. Okay, which is called as what? Filtrate. Okay, filtrate means what? Clear water. Okay, filtrate means what? Clear water. Okay, so after the filtration method, we are getting the clear water, which is called as what? Filtrate. And at the upside of the filter paper, we get the muddy particles. Okay, at the upper portion of the filter paper, we get the muddy particle, which is called as what? Residue. It's called as what? Residue. Residue means what? Muddy particles. Okay, muddy particles. Okay. So with the help of the filtration method, we are getting the filtrate at the bottom of the flask. That is what? Clear water. And at the upper portion of the filter paper, we will get the mud particles or the muddy particles. We can say the mud particles, which is called as what? Residue. Okay. So this is all about what? Filtration method. Now I hope that the water gets filtered. So after filtration, we have get this clear water, which is called as what? Filtrate. Which is called as what? Filtrate. And as I have told you before, that on the upper portion of the filter paper, we will get the muddy particles or the mud particles, which is called as what? Residue. So here you can see that mud particles. Okay. So this is what? Residue. So in this way, we can separate out the insoluble heavier substances from the liquid with the help of this sedimentation and decantation method, and also we can separate out these insoluble components from the liquid with the help of the filtration method. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We will meet in the next video with the next point, and for today, thank you.